This is the HDR-80 from Datavideo, a UHD 4K 60 ProRes recorder, which can of course support up to 10-bit 422 recording. But the real standout feature is that this can actually record 4 channels of 1080-60 simultaneously, whilst also giving you the ability to switch between those sources for a mixed program output. Monitoring and switching are done by the built-in 5-inch touchscreen, which really makes it a complete standalone production system, a multiviewer, recorder, and switcher. All of the connections are located on the back of the device, and for the video inputs you essentially have 4 SDIs, 3 are rated for 1080-60 and 1 for 4K60, and 2 HDMIs, one for 1080-60 and the other for 4K60. So here I've got 4 HD video sources connected. We have 2 PTZ cameras, a box camera, and the output of my laptop just playing some video content, connected using a mixture of HDMI and SDI. And on the front screen we can see all of our inputs. Now if I connect a monitor to either of the HDMI or SDI outputs available, or both, as they are active, I can simply tap on the source that I want to make live, and we can vision mix. If I tap on the top of each input, on the label, that source will go full screen and we can bring up some monitoring tools. We have focus peaking, zebras, RGB parade, waveform and vectorscope, and I can also tap and preview the shot fully. The front screen flips down and behind it are 2 2.5-inch SSD slots for your recording media. And you can see here I've got the OneDrive now loaded, so we can set which quality we want to record in. Once we've made our selection, we can hit record. We have confirmation that we're recording from the LED light on the front, and also by the red rectangle around the screen. We can still of course switch our sources and vision mix. When we're done, all of our ISO recordings are saved into the same folder, so we can play them back on the device for review. When in playback mode, the video is also outputted at the same time as shown on the screen, so you could actually use this as a playing in device for live productions too. You don't need to switch between 4 inputs, for example say you only need 3, you could feed the output of the unit back into the spare input. This way, we can vision mix between 3 video sources and record them along with recording the program output. All the recorded files will have timecode, so syncing in post is going to be very straightforward, and you do have timecode and genlock in and out on the rear. When you're recording a 4K source, you won't of course have the ability to vision mix, it just behaves as a standalone 4K recorder. It supports embedded audio for each of the input sources, along with having 2 XLR audio inputs. In terms of outputting, again we have 2 XLR audio outputs, and again we can embed on the program out. It's also compatible with various external controls via DVI-P, GPI or RS-232 interfaces, and also supports closed captioning over SDI, which is recorded in the metadata of the video files. So I hope you found this video useful guys. If you have any questions, just pop them in the comments and I will get back to you. And for more information, head over to the Holden website. Thanks for watching.